Good morning. Respected speaker of today's webinar, dignitaries and delegates of today's session, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to everyone. Today we have gathered virtually for the webinar on the art of designing web pages and insight, hosted by Department of BCA, Cayley Societies Degree College, Nagarbhavi. Before proceeding further, I would like to share a few words about Cayley Society and our department. Karnataka Lingayat Education Society, started in 1916, occupies a very special niche in the field of education, has now grown into a large institution that encompasses an autonomous university and over 270 institutions spread across the country and outside, with over 16,000 employees working to cater the needs of more than 1,25,000 students. The collaborations with universities in the US, UK and Malaysia have added a whole new dimension to the Cayley Society, making it on par with the reputed educational institutions worldwide. The Department of Bachelor of Computer Applications was started at Cayley Society's Degree College, Nagarbhavi in 2017 with the mission to provide high quality computer education to our students. The institution grooms its students to excel as future IT-tians. We have plenty of learning opportunities for our students. We are associated with ICT Academy, UiPath, Oracle, Palo Alto, AWS Academy, Micro Focus, and Salesforce. Today, we are hosting our second webinar series of Cloud Arena. The speaker of today's webinar is Mrs. V. Padma Priya, Assistant Professor in the Department of Computer Applications at BMS College of Engineering, Baswangudi, Bangalore. Her area of interest is in the domain of web technologies, mobile and wireless communication, ad hoc network, IoT, user interface and user experience design. Her decade-long tenure in field of education has her active participation in various college events with a special interest in the activities of women in engineering. Fueled by passion for teaching, she considers herself as forever student. Building a strong academic foundation with an urge to research and development and staying tuned to new trends and technologies in the field of computer applications is a motto. Now I request Padma Priya Madam to present her talk. Ma'am, it's over to you.
Thank you, Sneha. That was a wonderful introduction about Cayley and about me also. It was very humble. I would like to quote that Sneha is my student. I'm proud to be her teacher. Right. Very happy she is also a teacher like me. Right. Good to see her in that position. And thanks for the Cayley Society for giving me an opportunity to come over here. I have been seeing that there are 42 participants. I think there are heterogeneous participants. Right. I would like to keep it very simple, right, so that it caters to all category of people. Sneha knows me well, so I would not be dragging much, but I'll be very precise at this point. I'll start sharing the screen, Sneha.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
I'll stop the video now.
Sure, okay. Ma'am.
Hopefully, I'm audible to everybody.
Yes, ma'am. It's clear, ma'am.
Kindly look at the chat, because when I am doing my presentation, probably sure, I may not be able to.
Sure.
And all the participants, please feel free to stop me at any point, or at the end, I can also stay here for a Q&A session. You can also contact me at my email address. I'll always be, you know, there to help you. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, today's topic is an art of web designing and insight, right? I'm Padma Priya, as Sneha had already introduced. I work for BMS College of Engineering. I'm also alumni of the same college, and I've been in BMS College from past 12 years, right? And a lot of students have come from Cayley Society to our college. And it is good that I'm interacting with my own group of students in master's degree. Okay. I would start my presentation with this quote on knowledge versus imagination. The true sign of intelligence is not knowledge, but imagination, which is told by the great Albert Einstein. Why I am quoting this is sometimes only intelligence and knowledge is not enough, or to bring out that we need a lot of imagination. And web programming, web designing needs a very good combination of intelligence, knowledge, and huge amount of imagination. That is why I thought that this is the right thing to share with the people. Now, as a teacher, my advice to a student always would be, please have a book, make a note of the book, be very sharp like pencil, right? These are some advices only to students, right? I'm very sure teachers know about all these things. Make notes with pen so that it does not erase, because pencil can erase, right? So make notes in pen, keep it for a longer time. Highlight the points which are important, because throughout, highlighters important for our life, and achievement is also highlighting. So you should always have highlighters in life, in book, in textbook, everywhere. Always keep reading and gain knowledge. That's another advice from a teacher to the students fraternity. With this, with the blessings of Lord Ganesha, we already had Ganesha Chaturthi here recently, day before yesterday. I would like to start my talk. What is the agenda for the day? These are some of the things which I would like to look through. I'll give you a brief introduction to the art of web designing. I'll also go through a slight background on web designing with small use cases, how popular web designing are throughout the world, how people are getting confidence to move in this area, take it as a career. Then I would like to differentiate and make you understand what is UI and UX. Importantly, students always look forward for tools required, right? So I'll also give a small gist on what tools are required for this to go ahead with. And I'll conclude the session with a brief conclusion. Okay. If you can look at this, right, we have reached a digital era, right? There are a lot of things, lot of changes happening. If you see, children used to carry loads of books. As they grow, now they are carrying a laptop, notebook, or something like this. A lot of changes has brought because of digital era. I would not say that, no, today children don't carry book at all. No, they definitely they carry, but the load is getting reduced. I know there are students coming to college only with laptop, only with one book, and not this kind of load. That is one part. And the bottom part, we have corporate culture, which doesn't have any fixed way of sitting, right? And once again, it is a digital era. You can use different kinds of devices to communicate with each other. So throughout, our world is made up of so many things, right? So we are into digital era with right from childhood to corporate level to families. Everybody is using this digital media today. Okay, this is the world we are living in. All these images are predominantly images from India. We have this Sikshana, which is given for, you know, women in villages at the panchayat level, and they use different kinds of devices to educate them. If you are seeing, a mother is very happy with her children to see their results, you know, or the videos or online lectures from her own children. She is also learning. She is getting educated through children. The third one is predominantly on our, you know, urban culture, right? So where we are talking about urban areas where people are, you know, completely engrossed into their own devices. Then we have our student community, right, which is talking more on, you know, you can use your devices freely in the campus. Most of the campuses are now Wi-Fi enabled, and that is another picture. The next picture is very popular picture, releasing the results on internet is another popular picture. So we can see that children are happy seeing their results, right? And the last one is our villagers enjoying, maybe grandparents enjoying seeing digital media through the grandchildren. So this is another thing which is happening in the world. This is digital transformation of India as well. So we have covered most of the areas where digital transformation is happening. So because of this digital transformation, in India, there is a need, no, to create this kind of awareness. Now, what should a business house do in case it wants to reach a large group of people? Is marketing the only option, or is web presence an option? You can share your answers through chat. I'll be looking more into chat now. So if a business house wants to improve its business or reach large group of people, is it only that it should concentrate on marketing, or it should also concentrate on web presence? Anything else? Please put your answers in chat. I'll be looking at it. So Anil says web presence, Satvik says web presence, Kavya says both. Very good. Any other answers? Good. Asif says both. Yes, many answers are both. Nothing else? Only these two are required? Nothing else? Any other idea? Web presence is required. Kiran says web presence is required. Good. So it's a mixture. Think they need both. It is marketing and web presence. Digital marketing. Yes. Fine. Good. Both are required. Okay. So it's a good combination of web presence should be there, and marketing and web presence should also be there, or digital marketing should be there. Correct. Correct. That is absolutely right. Next question to all the participants is, do you think that you can make a career in web designing? Do you think you can make a career in web designing? Yes. You okay? But I think good answers. Predominantly, yes. But most of you joined the BCA thinking that it will be more on coding. But I said at the introductory session, it is not only on coding. You should also be very creative. Imagination. And I doubt any teacher will allow anybody to imagine and dream in class. Right? But good. Yes. Predominantly people say, yes, using web, right? Web designing is very good career option. Yes. Please consider that as a career option. Correct. All of you. I agree with all of you. Thank you for your answers. Okay, I'll move ahead now. Okay, now what is web designing as the concept, right? It is a process of planning, conceptualizing, and arranging content which are intended for the internet. So this is the broad definition of a web design. So you have to plan how things will be looking. You should also conceptualize how, what elements will come, what widgets will come, what items will come, and also arrange them based on the context. And that is intended to be for our digital media, rendered through the network of large group of computers, which is called as internet. So modern web design goes beyond how things were looking, right? That is your aesthetics. Now it has to tell how things will work. That means it should also concentrate on functionality. So web design is not limited to websites today. You should have affinity to design web apps, mobile apps, and you should also bring in the concept of user interface design. A good web design has a huge impact on the websites or business houses where the performance is rated in the search engines. So all of you have answered that, yes, we need web designing. Yes, web designing can be made as a career. Correct. So you should think beyond programming. You should think to make it work. Today, only web designing, only websites will not work. Web apps are required. Mobile apps are required. And catchy user interfaces are required. And it should also perform well in a search engine. So it has a lot of constraints in doing this. Okay. These are some of my thoughts, right? And all the images are taken from Google. So Google also is my guru. I've taken all these thoughts from Google. Some of the thoughts are very beautiful, very relevant. We don't just sell websites. We create websites that sell. So don't just create websites. Make the websites sellable is one of the thought. everybody is a web designer until you know they actually try to do it. So I'm a designer. You can't keep quiet. Bring it to action. Actually try to do it. Let it, it is okay to fail, but let there be an attempt. Good design begins with honesty. Ask tough questions. Comes from asking your tough question, which comes from collaboration and from trusting your intuition. Sometimes your intuition tells you are correct. Go with your intuitions. Collaborate with people. Ask questions. Be honest with the client. All of them will give you success in this area. Don't take some things from the client and say you end up in something else, right? So you shouldn't be doing that. Be very honest. Ask questions as many times as possible. Collaborate with people and start developing trust and believe your intuitions also. With all these things, quality is everybody's responsibility. So once you follow all of them, I think quality is a nature which comes with it, and it is everybody's responsibility. When I go with intuitions, when I ask questions, when I'm being very honest, when I know what I'm doing, I'm also carrying the responsibility of giving a quality product to the community. So make sure that you don't just sell websites, no, sell, create it only for being sold. That's another thing. Have a very good quality and give lot of imagination to your websites. Okay, so what do I need to know before I start web designing? Now I'll be looking at the chat window. Please tell me on the chat window. What do I need to know before I start web designing? I think Mohammed Asif Kamal is asking, I have a question, which programming language is best for web designing? Asif, I'll come to it later, definitely. But I think I would not restrict first people to talk about programming language, right? I'll come and answer the question. So what is required for web designing? That was the question. Sneha, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Is my screen seen?
No, ma'am. It is
okay. Visible. Yeah. Yes. What do I need to know before I start web designing? Should I know, like Asif asked, should I know the programming language before? Should I know programming language? Database and programming languages. Okay. Should I note that? Okay. Any other answer? Front and back end coding. Good. Okay. Technical ability. Okay. Fine. But in my introductory talk, I told we need a lot of imagination. I have technical capability, but I am not able to imagine anything. Designing skills. Sanjay tells designing skills. Good. Good. Most of the answers are nearing. Same front and back end coding, how to design a form, HTML. Pujita Chaitra says you should know HTML. Kavya says creativity. Good. Yes. Fine. Okay. Fine. Thank you. What do I need to know before I start web designing? So, I think these things you need to know. Need of the hour is to design interfaces which cater to different screen size, resolution, devices, OS, and for a different category of people, right? So you need not know HTML, CSS, JavaScript, database, any of them. First, see, can you understand what are these screen sizes? Do you know different resolutions? Somewhere people talked about technical capability. Do you know what kind of devices are used across the globe? What are the different operating systems? And are they differently abled people? Are they different category of people, right? If I give a mobile app or a website for a person who cannot see, then is it voice enabled? That's another thing which you need to see, right? If I give a person who cannot speak, what should the website convey? how should the website convey it to a person with differently abled person like this. So first you should know what are the interfaces, what are the screen sizes, what are the resolutions, and so on. The next step, okay, is not to code, but to understand the user and his requirements. Please do not start coding, right? All of you would have done this. Once your teacher tells do this, you'll first go open a notepad and start typing, right? Please do not do that, but understand the user and his requirements. Third one, capture the requirements in the form of user stories. Talk to user, convey to him, ask him questions, keep on asking questions, right? And then draw a wireframe. Don't draw or don't code something, right? Wireframe can be drawn even in hand with a paper and a pen, or there are wireframe softwares which will help you to capture all your requirements. Wireframe software will tell you how a homepage will look, how will you transit from one page to another page, and all those things what a user has taught, right? So there's a classic example of, you know, some of the banks' website being very bad with color combination, right? There are user stories written for it. That means at the initial phase, they did not capture the requirements properly. They did not understand the user stories properly, and they did not draw the wireframe before they went to customer. What they did, they created the website and just went and told, this is your website. We have hosted it at this place. Please do not do that, right? So capture the requirements, keep the stories. User story capturing is a very big topic. Sometimes if I get an opportunity, I'll also tell you how to create. We can also do a hands-on where we can create a user story and do the wireframe. The next one is to prepare a draft and explain it to the user, giving the visual content of his story. So story is visualized with the visual content. Once again, there are tools available. You need not build website. So identify all the elements which are required for a very good website design. Don't start coding. Don't think about programming language at this phase, right? So if I have to answer the question, what do I need to know before I start web designing? It is not HTML, it is not CSS, right? It is not any other capability. It is to understand the user and his perspective. Okay. Now, what are the elements to create a good web design, right? Some are visual elements. Most of the times, web programming is more on visual content. So content and the design should go hand in hand. You should have good content. You should have good design. A very good combination of both of them only will work. Choose easy to read fonts pairs, right? Most of them that are from your Google fonts, and let it complement with the design, right? Choose easy to read fonts, which should complement with your design, and use most popular Google fonts, or there is a web safe fonts. Okay. Then you can also concentrate on colors, right? Colors are very important. You should have a very good combination of colors, right, to render it to the website. Decide on the layout. Should I have, you know, three vertical column layout, one horizontal column, two horizontal column, elements, spacing, and all those things? I think there are hand raises. I'll definitely answer your question. I'll answer everybody's question. I'll just finish, come to one point, and I'll take the question. Have a good image and video quality and animation techniques. Please follow that you have a good image created by you, have a good video quality, and also have good animation techniques. Let it not run away from the screen. Provide good navigation. Let user not be lost when he is moving from one page to another page, right? So give him a good transition or web crawl, what we say, from one page to another page. Also check for cross-browser compatibility. Keep in mind, we are talking about devices which are of different sizes, different operating system, and their capabilities are different. So you should have a good combination of all these things, and it should also work across several browsers. So content is the king, design is also king. So content is king and queen. Nothing is greater to each other. Fonts are quite visible, and they should complement with your design. Color combinations are to be taken care. Layout should not be hazy. Images, videos, or the MIME content, multimedia content, should be very good in quality. I was talking about quality aspect. then you should have good navigation. User should not lose their path. Now, this is not going to be a trekking path for him. It should have a very good transition, and it should also provide cross-browser compatibility, right? So these are some of the things which are very much essential for a visual element of a web design. See this, this is what I say. Content first, optimize the content, let it render to different kinds of audiences, choose a good font, keep track of the colors. This is a right combination of doing which color, which font, which kind of devices, what should be the content, how should the media be represented. This is just a small representation of summary of the previous slide. Okay, before I go to this, can I take the question? Yeah, I have somebody. There was a hand raise. Sneha, there was a hand raise.
Yes, ma'am.
There was a hand raise. I don't know.
Ma'am, you can continue, ma'am. I'll talk in chat.
Yeah. Okay, sure. Okay. Now we come to the next point of types of websites. Though there was a whole bunch of website design. People were telling there was fixed website design, static website design, fluid design. These were the ones which are already there in the world. But today's world is mobile first world. So there are two ways of designing a website. First one is called as adaptive websites. The other one is called as a responsive website. If you look at the next sentence, that will answer most of your question. Best part is that with modern design tools, you don't need to know how to code to build a stunning website that looks great on all the devices. So coding is not the only thing. You don't even need to know what coding is. But yes, at a long run, you should know how to handle this coding and do it with your server combination. You don't need to know complete coding to design a very good website. Even without the knowledge of the website, knowledge of these coding techniques, you can still build a very good website. So we'll go into what is called as adaptive websites. So adaptive web design uses two or more versions of the websites, which will customize for different screen sizes. So it will customize itself to the screen size. It is not for a desktop, laptop, mobile. No, it wouldn't do that. If you observe, it does for pixels. 1080 pixel, okay, this is how the website will look. 768 pixel, this is how it will look. If the width is 480 pixels, this is how it will look. So adaptive websites will detect the category and the version that has to be displayed based on the screen resolution size, right? And it also tells the websites, okay, these are the medias, these are the breakpoints, you'll have to look from one place to another place. It'll also give lot of flexibility when designing your website, and it'll be more responsive when you look at them in the screen size and not based on the desktop, laptop, or the mobile version. This is one kind of thought. Adaptive website is one kind of thought. The other kind of thought is responsive websites, which is a combination of grids, right? Now here, it is based on percentage. A width is 100%, width is 20%. So you look at percentage and you will not look at pixel level. So there are breakpoints where you can customize it for a screen size. If you closely observe, both of them may look totally same, adaptive and responsive, but unlike adaptive sites, they adapt only when they hit the breakpoint. Only when it goes beyond a control, then only responsive websites will come. And they'll be constantly changing with the screen size. It is as good as if you're seeing a video in a Netflix, Amazon Prime, or somewhere, right? You cannot see a vertical view. When you play a video, it already becomes a horizontal view. It adapts and it is also being responsive. Responsive because you may be seeing it on a desktop, or you may also be seeing it on a mobile with a different screen size. So it's both adaptive and responsive in nature. Remember, responsive always takes percentages. Adaptive takes pixel level details. These are other two major categories where people are looking into website building. Okay, now let's see. These are our popular ranked websites, right? Why I gave this quote on the right? He's a famous person, Dale Carnegie. He says, knowledge is in power until it is applied. So I know so many things in my mind, but I have not applied it. Then it is not conceptualized, it's not visualized, it is not put onto the environment. Then there is no use of such kind of knowledge. Have knowledge, have wisdom, bring it into wisdom, have lot of imagination. So how were these 10 websites ranked, and which were the websites which were ranked? Okay, best website design winner. So this is the one which is called newchapter.com, right? So this is something to do with fitness people, those who take fitness protein shakes, tablets, and all those things. So newchapter.com was designed for them. This you can always browse and check. But importantly, I would want to you to understand what did the reviewer say about this website, right? New Chapter's content and education focused approach really helps visitors understand the benefits of their products. So what are their products? What are the contents of their products? All those things are clearly listed in that page. Plus, they have employed a great use of categorization, allowing the visitors to select supplements based on health needs or ingredients. So based on ingredients, based on somebody's health needs, they can do this categorization. And if you observe the web page, it's a combination of light green, grayish green, lavender, white. So there are only three predominant colors in this place, right? And white is always pleasing, right? Because it's a wellness thing. White is always pleasing in nature. So they have taken newchapter.com as one of the best design of website with minimal color, right? And very good categorization, good understanding for the users as well. Okay. Next was this something called as blissworld.com. Once again, now we'll start looking at the website. It is white, teal green and blue, right? And one predominant color is a shade of pink to lavender, which is coming on the top, and yellow or orange, which is showing you the offers just arrived and all those things. This is once again a very pleasing color for people to come, right? So what does the reviewer say? Look, the reviewer. Reviewer is a woman, right? So she understands who should come to this website, what kind of people will come to this site. This site has a fresh, beautiful, and engaging overall design. My favorite attribute is the color scheme and photography. If you remember, I told media is one of the things which is very important for a website to show. So the clarity and the photography is one thing which has caught the reviewer's eye. From the layout to the color scheme and the product images, the website design complements the brand promise that inner happiness leads to outward beauty. I know it's a beauty product, but inner happiness also matters, which is reflected on the face. There's no bias, but still it is more women-centric, female-centric in nature. The third website, probably everybody will like this. It's our food website, bonbonbon.com. You would have seen the competitors are Swiggy, Zomato. There are many which are having colorful, beautiful pages like this. Right? There are many like this, but this is also one of the third finalists for this contest. Let's see what the reviewer Tom told. This is an energetic and personable site that does an excellent job of going beyond a template feel. There is no template feel. It is do it yourself kind of a project. This is a story which was a Detroit DIY company which bought the story of this food thing into picture. So this is another website which has a very beautiful design for food. So we cater to wellness, we cater to beauty, we cater to food business. Next, this is another one. Many people are crazy about headphones, their devices today. So the one which boosts our mind is definitely our music. So Skull Candy is another best new site winner, right? So what did the reviewer think about this site? Judge Tom once again says that this is superior design that emulates an established brand. The backstage pass stories are an excellent content feature. It's a very good photography. It has very good color combination and a very good case study for a big e-commerce platform to offer. So these are some of the appreciations who judged this particular website. Here I have just given you the home page. Probably if you go deeper into this, I have shared the slides already. If you go deeper into this, you'll understand why did the judge tell all these, you know, good things towards the website design. Next, most of you can relate it to Nike, right? Truelinkswear.com is a newcomer, right? And he just meant what business they are into. The closest you'll get to walking barefoot without getting grass stains on your feet is their tagline. Now they are also available at this place and all those things, right? So what did the judge think? I love a homepage that makes 100% clear what the product is and why I should care. This is done very well by this particular newcomer of the website. Product pages are really nice too. That's a place where carousel actually works. Also, blog posts are very good. You can see a lot of things doing this, and he said kudos to this website. Take a look at the website once again, right? It simply means what they want to convey. It is not having many tabs. It doesn't have multiple things. It has one image and a very clear image for this. And it has a lot of other things also related to this. Okay. Next is on, once again, a wireless headphone, decibuls.com, right? They also talk about different kinds of headphones. They also talk about how to protect your ears, right? Because headphones for longer duration of time may kill germs, very good germs for which are in our ears. And it may also damage some part of the hearing system in our body. So how to handle this headphones if you are wearing it for a longer time, right? So this is another revolution. Wireless headphone is a very popular one today. And then is on cars. This is jeeppeople.com, right? They predominantly talk about the vehicles, what kind of vehicles, where do we service, who are their competitors, how do you shop by brand and all these things. These are newcomers in the area of design. So once again, concentrate on color schemes, orange, black, white, and the good picture quality. Concentrate on color schemes, white, gray, and the image is also gray. Once again, completely black and white with gray. So you have a simple, subtle combination of contents, color schemes. Fonts are very good. Look at their logo. If you look at their logo, it's also designed in black. All other contents are also designed in black. So it's a very nice, simple 2 to 3 color combination. I said color also should match and the fonts also should match. Okay, next we come to best e-commerce homepages. Okay, does homepage really matter to people? That is what people were thinking. It's okay, it is a place which is a landing place, right? So homepage is fine. No, many people say that homepage is worth for lot of things in e-commerce business. 30% of the share of the business actually comes from the homepage. This means you need to be very clearly conveying your brand expertise, trustworthiness, and community will quickly take this. It is like a magnet to attract people. What are the things people would be looking at your homepage? Do a little bit of storytelling. The user stories can be bought into about us page or our story page or something. Keep it simply. Don't have lot of things. Very simple mentality should be there. Content should be very simple. A video, if possible, to describe. Today, we have 360 degree videos and all those things. You can definitely do. You can push your brand proposition. You can have your advertisements put in the front sheet. Also, let know people what is your social media handle, right? Social proof your customers. Don't allow them to run away from this website. Let them know where you are, how you are reachable. Then what are the merchandise which you are selling in case it is an e-commerce portal, services which you are giving, and if there are new products or promotions, please give it in a conspicuous colors, right? That's another thing which you should be doing. So these are some things on which a best homepage design was decided. This is the webpage, aztecsoccer.com. I went to this webpage and it brought me Hindi version also. If you can see, there's an Indian flag here and the words are written in Hindi, that means it has got too much of regionalization. Very good. If a person cannot understand English, he can still buy this in his own language. It has so many language support. Not to worry. You can go to the website. You can see host of languages based on the country. They do this. And importantly, this is meant only to give information about the shoes which are used with soccer. That is the brand which they are promoting. Very simple homepage convey. What did this judge talk about? This site shows great use of bright products. Photos are very well combined. It is showing lifestyle products, and visitors can simply explore and find out in a single click and also in their native languages. Next, there is something called as organic milk. Too many people are worried about the contamination which we have in the milk which we get. Many people are going towards this organic word, right? So they talk about organic nut milk and how with the flavors and all those things. This website talks totally about organic products, especially the dairy products, right? So it is very simple. Once again, if it is cocoa, the bottle is brown, right? And if it is original, they have their original white and blue combination. It's another simple sample one, which has white and white combination. The whole website is light gray, dark gray, blue combination. That is all, right? You can browse through this freshfrancs.com. Once again, clean design, right? Not showing many things, but showing relevant bottles. You can click on each of the bottle and see. The copy is wonderfully clear and explains exactly what the product or services. They make nut milks and deliver it them. And it's a very simple message. They use almond milk or different kinds of milk, and that is their business. They're not mixing many things in this place. That is once again a very catchy thing in a homepage. Okay, what are the parameters? Once again, the overall parameters for measuring a website is to create a great user experience through branding consistency. You have to maintain consistency. Brand consistency is very important. Good user experience is important. If I am seeing this on my mobile device, how will the bottle look, right? Will it look one after the other? Will it look next? Will I get a small view or will I get a very big view? So all these things you should be able to take care. Mobile responsive, because we are mobile first generation now, and a friendly UX, user experience should also be very friendly, and it should have a very quick checkout process. You should put it into cart, and after cart, it should give you a clear instruction of how to check out this particular product. Okay, so this is how the designing should take place. Parameters on which the above websites were ranked. Okay, now we will actually come to what are these two terms which are making huge noise in the industry. You should have a knowledge about what is an user interface and what is a user experience. So we have few definitions. We'll see those definitions, and after that we'll understand it in deeper. User interface design or user interface engineering is a design of user interfaces for machines and softwares like computers, home appliances, mobile devices, or other electronic devices, with the focus on maximizing usability and the user experience. So user interface design is an engineering technique for designing a user interface for different machines, different softwares, different devices, and not only simple devices, it could be other electronic devices also. User interface design focuses on, or this is another alternative definition, anticipating what user might need to do and ensuring that the interface has elements that are easy to access, understand, and use to facilitate those actions, right? So the website is easy to access for me. I understand clearly what products they are selling. I also see that whatever actions I take, it is leading to the right answers. UI brings together concepts from interaction design, visual design, and information architecture. So you'll have to do all these things. You should see how elements will interact with each other, how visually appealing they are, and what is the information architecture they are using. So user interface design includes everything to understand a user. Okay, the predominant difference between what is UI and what is UX. What to make? Are these the usual elements which I am using? Are these desirable elements which I am using? What for tools to focus on is coming under UI. So many of you told, right, ma'am, what language should I use? Which tool to use? All those things are part of your UI designing, user interface designing. When I come to user experience, what to achieve? How should the experience be different? How credible is the experience? Is this available to all the users? Can users see it in different screen size? Will the interaction be same across all the devices? All those things are taken care by user experience. Both of them go hand in hand. They are faces of the same coin. So if you have a very good user interface, your experience should answer what you have achieved, right? So here, focus on UI is on tools. Focus on UX is on interaction. Very simple example. Today in the situation of COVID, all of you are seeing thermal sensors, right? Thermal sensors, nobody will come and touch our body and keep the thermometer, which is generally done by a doctor. Physical thermometer, either digital or analog thermometer, is kept in your mouth to measure your temperature. But gone are those days, right? Today with the current scenario, you cannot use that kind of device. So you'll have to move on to something which is contactless. That is what we say in case of a thermal sensor. Now it is, if we have to measure body temperature of a child, of a newborn baby, then thermal sensor is very good. But they already have a device which is like a sweater for the baby. It's a coat for the baby. Just put the coat onto the baby and that will send the measurements of the body vitals, including its heartbeat, you know, how is its breathing, what is its current temperature. All those things are measured by that coat, right? So this is another thing. And there is a baby feeder kind of a thing, infant feeder, that will tell at this point of time how much milk is required for this particular infant. So that's an experience. So I didn't have any mobile device. That bottle measure told me that it was connected to the parent's device, told me whether the baby was hungry, should it be fed, what is its body vitals. All these things are given through the devices like this. So it is focused on the interaction and not on the focus of the tools here. So the major difference between UI and UX is this. So what to make, what to achieve. Visual elements, experiences. Desirable, yes, they are credible. Whatever I desired, I got it. I did focus on tools. I'm now focusing on how it interacts with the other tools. This is an overview of what UI and UX is all about. So why does UI UX matter to us today? Can't we do a simple web design and keep quiet? Why should we do all these things? Today is a fast-paced society. We are using application and we want the application to respond very quickly, irrespective of what kind of device we are using, what kind of connections we are using. We don't bother. We want the website to be very quick with us. Design and software is now heavily based on user experience. We want all the customers to be satisfied. So user experience is utmost important. I cannot tell this particular website will not work with this particular mobile, with Android, Jelly Bean, KitKat, or Pi, or anything. I can't give that kind of specification. I cannot tell that this is the application which is going to work only in iOS. No, there are some applications like that, but you shouldn't be ending up with that kind of applications. If website takes 15 seconds longer to find specific products, please read, it is 15 seconds longer to find a specific product as compared to your competitor site. That means no, your website report shows that you are slow compared to your competitor. So if Amazon and Flipkart are giving year-end sale, season sales, end of the season sale, both of them should be very quick in responding. You cannot say Amazon is fast, Flipkart is slow, because internally search engine optimizer will tell by how many minutes the checkout could not take. What is the lag in this? It could be due to several reasons, but still it will take all those things into consideration. Often users search the web in essence of knowing generally what they want to find. So you should know what they want to find and how they're going to reach. Don't leave loose ends. Don't break the navigation. Give them what they want to find. That is why all these things matter. Even if they are simply browsing, it is up to you and your user interface or experience designers to make them navigate to other places in your site and not leave it to your competitor. Whether you are selling a product or a service, make sure that you get the business. That is what is simple thing which you'll have to understand. So most of the times, web designing is about business. It's about commerce. So you should make either your product or service to be sellable. That is another important thing which you should take care. So don't be slow, be very efficient, be quick, have very good user interface, have a very good combination which is given by this user interface and user experience. That is why it matters. Okay, now what is the importance and who are using? See on the right, I have PayPal, Airbnb, Google Store are all supposed to be ranked the best in user experience in 2020. All these examples what I am showing is rated up to February 2020 and not beyond that. I am yet to get some of them. So what does a UX design aid for people? User satisfaction, conversion optimization, reduce costs and maintenance. It will reduce development and documentation cost, increase app installation. Too many app installation will happen. So you are no longer into only web apps. You also have mobile apps now. Increase average time of retention. How long you want the customer to stay so that he takes the product or the service. Increase sales and drive customer loyalty. Make him to come back to your web page, right? Increase the sale. Track him. Send emails to him. Send notification. Send alerts. Right? Have a chatbot. Something like that so that you have the customer with you and the business expands with this. Keep him satisfied, right? Also, don't be slow. All these things are to be done. If you look at Google Store and if you look at Airbnb or PayPal and all those things, they're holding people and they're making sure that you have come to their website back. Now, this answers most of the questions students want to know. What are the programming tools and languages? Tools, Photoshop, Dreamweaver, WordPress, Google Web Designer, all these things to be learned before you start learning HTML, CSS, Bootstrap, and any of them, right? So you should know some basic tools of designing, but this is not going to fill your bread and butter. A combination of all these things should be doing it. Language, yes, the basic languages, HTML, DHTML, CSS, Bootstrap, all of them are fine. Then we have scripting language, which are the heart of client-side programming. JavaScript, VBScript, Ajax, jQuery. Today we have TypeScript, very popular. We have languages like Go, very popular. ActionScript, React.js. Today is the world of React.js. Then server-side scripting or programming languages. Perl is very old. PHP is also old, but very popular. Lot of frameworks with PHP. Python, Java, and Node.js. Node.js, React.js is a deadly combination today. You can have this very good combination, learn all of them. So your basic should go like this. If you ask me as a teacher to be a very good web designer, you would have knowledge of all these things, plus knowledge of XML, extensible markup language, JSON. You should know relational databases, non-relational databases, structured database, unstructured database. That means MySQL, MongoDB, Postgre, and all of them. You should also know how to work with servers. XAMPP, LAMPP, WAMPP, MeanStack, all of them should be there. So as a student, if you're looking at this slide, you have a host of things to learn. I've just put some 10% of the content, which is very popular among all the students. That is what I have put. But have all these things in mind, right? Some of them are old, but still they are very good today. And I would always recommend to use something which is open source, free to use, right? And not proprietary at the student's level. Once you go to company, you may have all these facilities of buying the software, then you can use them, right? So use all of the open source resources that will be easy for you to work with. So this is for all the students who want to know what tools, technologies, and many more are there. There are many more. These are the crisp ones which I have put here. Okay, so these are the tools which you should be using and programming languages which you should be learning. Finally, I would end up this with a very nice quote. Designing websites when you don't have a copy yet is your motto. Design a website. Don't take a template and say, I have added to this template. Your template should be picked by somebody. So design a website when they don't have the business, when they don't have the idea, collect the user requirements, and there is no copy yet. So you will put your mark in the web designing industry. This is what a web designer is expected to know at the end. So don't copy it from different places. Nothing wrong in copying. I understand that we can use a lot of free open source templates. Please have their logos or their copyrights and all those things. Like we call web ethics. Please maintain web ethics in all those contexts, and designing websites should be very happy to go with, right? So have your first copy. Don't take from the other copies. That is what is required for a web designer. Okay, these are some of the references which I have used, and I would strongly recommend you all to go to these places and look lot of information and about all the things which I have spoken in my slide today. Thank you, and this is my contact details. You can contact me, keep in touch with me through these email addresses. Sneha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. It was a wonderful talk.
And hopefully, I have conveyed what people wanted to know.
Yes, ma'am. So now the session is open for question and answers. Participants can post their questions in chat box.
Or if you want to come over and chat is also fine. Voice, you can come over voice and also talk.
Ma'am, hopefully that would be a disturbance, ma'am, if I unmute everyone.
Yeah. Okay. I am reading some of them. There was no voice. Sorry, madam, I did not.
Ma'am, I've answered them actually.
Okay. Please post your questions to me. You can send it by email. If it has to be kept as a very crisp session, right? You can send it as email. I'll answer each one of your question, right? And definitely you can connect to me through my email address. Being in final year, which is the best platform to do our projects, web designing projects, I'll recommend you to take MeanStack, Mongo, Express, Node, and React. MEAN. Mongo, Express. Are you there? Mongo, Express, React, and Node. So you should have that.
And there's one more question.
Yeah.
What is the use of CSS float in web designing?
Float is very good thing, right? You have this box model, if you remember, right? There is a box model which will set your margin, padding, and all those things. That will set your visual elements, right? If you don't have CSS float element, like you have a static element, you have a dynamic element. So if you don't have that float element, you won't know where your image will come if I change the size and screen width. That is why I told adaptive and responsive. In case of adaptive, these things are very good. CSS float plays a very useful part for that, because it is very closely associated with the box model. I have completed MCA, so BCA, where should I do my MCA? Please come to our college. I'll always tell that. How difficult it is the web designing course for beginners? No, it is not difficult. Sneha knows the answer.
Yes.
Please ask your madam. It is not difficult at all. Definitely you can start. There is no basic requirement except for creativity. Thank you. It was a very informative. How difficult? Okay. What are the things to learn to make website responsive? Yes, there are a lot of things to know about responsive website. So in most of the places, in a very brief note, I'll tell you, if you're working on Google Chrome or Mozilla, right, you can inspect the page and check for the responsiveness of the page, right? So most of these things are available in Bootstrap. Instead of working only with HTML, start working with Bootstrap. Bootstrap has something like an API or some additional widgets which will allow you to make your page or a website more responsive in nature. So you can look at Bootstrap, or for your first level of curiosity, open Google Chrome, right click on a page and say inspect elements, right? When you say inspect elements, you have some content which will talk about responsive content. So you can see, change the screen size based on the mobile device. It'll tell you how responsive the website is. Yes, you can do it to satisfy your curiosity. Any link where I can join beginners web designing course? Please do not take courses now. Start with W3 schools, tutorials point, and all these places. Later you can do it on the courses. There is two big role of imagination. One example, madam, I have, sorry, sir, I think one person like Dr. Ajay Shukla has talked about what is the major role of imagination, creativity, innovation, and honesty in web designing. I'll put it in the reverse direction. Honesty is utmost important in business to reach people. If you're not honest about your overall design, then probably your sustenance for longer interval of time may not happen. Innovation and creativity are part of today's e-commerce or any environment, right? If you don't innovate, you're no longer there. For example, the best web designs which I told was still talking about selling the same organic milk, right? In our terms, they would have talked about a packet, right, which is sold by Nandini, Mother Dairy, and all of them. They made that bottle look. It also tells that I am sending you through a glass bottle. So that is another creativity and innovation. Flavors, catering to different kinds of people. Creativity also comes in catering to people who are very specific or allergic to some kind of milk or something. Imagination, the colors, right? Colors and all these things are very important. On a very lighter note, because this is an open platform, I would not like to name these websites. They may feel offensive about this. There was one popular place. The combination was maroon and yellow. People did not like that combination at all. They started telling the company, please do not go with color combination. It is very bright. People will not come. They said that, no, my manager likes or my CEO likes these two colors, and we want the website in maroon and yellow only. So our creativity is gone. Our innovation is gone. But still, we were honest in telling them that, right, your page will not be convincing to many people. After many years, their logo still is in yellow and maroon, but their whole page has changed. Over years, they have realized that this may not happen. Okay, few interesting ones. Bluetooth-based behavior model, okay, nice. M2M solution, remote server monitoring, yeah, correct. All those things would be something which is for a final year BCA. Thank you, Noor Fatima, madam. That was a very good one. Thank you all. I think I have answered the questions. Thanks for the support from KLE College. Thanks for giving me an opportunity. Please feel free to connect to me through my email address. And thanks, Neha, for giving me an opportunity. Hopefully I'm on time, right? I generally don't skip the time, right? And I am on time. Okay. Yes. I would appreciate all of you, please give your honest feedbacks, right? If there is anything required from my end, I can come back on one more session.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you. So now we have come to the end of the session. On behalf of our management, the institution, and the organizers, I thank speaker of today's webinar, Mrs. V. Padmapriya Madam, for enthralling the audience with her talk. And I'm thankful to Professor Vijay Kumar AS, Principal, KLE Societas Degree College, for successfully organizing the webinar. I thank faculty members of Department of BCA for helping to organize this webinar. The response we got for this webinar was overwhelming, and it is your active participation which motivates us to conduct more webinars. From the bottom of my heart, I thank all the participants for making this webinar a grand success. Our next webinar will be on 26th. The registration details will be shared in chat box and feedback link as well. Participants who want the resource of presentation of Madam, I'll be sharing that here in the Zoom. Well, thank you so much for your participation.
Thank you all. Okay. Sneha, I would leave the meeting.
Yes, ma'am. Sure, ma'am.
Thank you.
I'll get back to you, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.